Oh, hi, Addie. Yeah, thank you. I appreciate that. Yep. Yep. Yep, yep. Are you okay? No, you just went and got a drink. I see, I see. I see what's going on here. You're aspirating. You're coughing. You're okay. You're fine. You're cool. Everything is fine. I have the top of my cowboy hat tonight, so that's good. I think that's good. And we should probably get started. We are going to attempt to maybe finish Red Dead Redemption tonight. I'm not sure. But we'll figure it out. We'll be right back after this brief message, which isn't a message at all, it's just the credits. Prompt to ride the horse. But Addie wants some attention first. Don't you? Hope everyone is having a good Friday or Saturday where you are. And we're just going to continue here. I think, if I remember correctly, and I might not, but if I remember, this next mission is the one that will open up the area to the north, I'm not even sure where I need to go. Let's just go to Chuparosa. I should have checked the map, but I didn't do it. For reasons, you know? Reasons. Did I overshoot it? What do we do here? Hi, John. How you doing? Still not the map button. Where? Oh, I need to go all the way over to Escalera? Okay. I guess that makes sense. I should see if there's anything worth buying real quick. Although I don't think there is. My turn, get out of the way.
How are you, mister?
I can always refill on these. I heard gunshots. I didn't shoot. Who shot? Who's shooting? What are you guys doing? What is happening here? I am so confused. What if I just get on my horse and leave?
Let's go.
I don't know what that was all about. Whoa.
Come on.
Good luck. Yo, Meech, thank you very much for the good luck. I'm doing all right. Can't complain too much. Future, thank you for saying hi to me. Hope you are both having good ones. I don't have to help anything.
Come on.
We're gonna try to wrap this up tonight. If I don't wrap this up tonight, I will know when the final mission is. And what I will probably do over the weekend is try to prep this so that we can do one of the very cool extra missions. And then do the final mission. The final mission is quite long, by the way. And Addy, I don't know what you're doing over there.
Hey.
Good. Thank you. People don't pay to see me, they pay to see you. Hang on a second. What is that? What is that? What is this? How did that get there? Goof. Oh my goodness. Future, thank you for your contribution to the Zelda challenge. I appreciate it.
Let's go. Come on.
All right, we should be getting close here. If I remember, this mission is going to be, yeah. Can we, of course, can we get unstuck? No. There's a whole bunch of dead bodies here. What did I miss? If you don't mind me, you can grieve all you want. I just need that stuff. I like the shotgun. That seems all right. But this should be where it pops off.
Quítate, estúpido. Le voy a dar un balazo. Quítate. Quítate, pendejo. Quítate. Una, dos, tres. ¡Bang! ¡Bang!
¡Que viva México! ¡México
viva! ¡Viva la revolución!
No, no, para atrás, para atrás. Usted para atrás. Para atrás.
Otra vez.
Welcome to Mexico. My brothers and I are just discussing the future of our country.
Okay, let this man go.
And who are you, gringo?
I'm no one. But unless you want this town to tear you and your boys to shreds, I suggest you let him go.
And you think you could tell me what to do, friend?
Oh, you should listen to him, friend.
Look at that. You want to risk it?
The American is a drunk. If I were you, I would pull that trigger.
Put the gun down, Americano.
Ya, ya, mátalo.
Dejen mi hombre.
Mierda.
Huh? Ay, Dios mío.
Santa Maria.
So you want to settle this now, friend? Or you want me to shoot you in the head right now for that poor girl?
Okay, but we fight like men, not like dogs.
No problem. We'll do it. I think I got him.
Thanks, my brother. Now the people are finally ready. Today we overthrow the Coronel.
Rest in peace, my friend.
Hurry, my friend, set me free.
What if I just shot you instead? Ugh. This is a very odd mission.
We must escape now while we have the chance.
At least the intro. Because that's pretty much exactly how I remembered it.
Senor, there are prisoners in jail who will fight on our side. Can you save them?
Some of my best men are held in Allende's jail. They will be a great help to us.
Go to the jail. All right, well, let's check the map and just see where that is in relation to me. Okay. Anything down here? Anything good? No. Dead bodies everywhere. Whoa! Enjoy your 11 exit practice, Meech. Are you practicing regular 11 exit, or are you practicing the ROM hack 11 exit? Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. I want to retry. ROM hack, okay. It'd be interesting.
Marchamos sobre la mansión de Allende. Right,
so I need to. I need to not get shot. I don't know why I got shot there.
You're going to inferno, my friend!
Nat, hello! Hope you're doing well. I am planning this weekend to catch up on your ESSA run. I still have not seen it, but I have heard that it seemed like it went pretty well. Congrats again on having a featured run. Hope you were able to enjoy your time there. Oh, I'm on why am I on fire? I didn't even step into the fire. Aside from being on fire, I'm doing alright, Nat. How are we gonna approach the jail here? We're gonna go into the marker. Got it. You're not coming back from that.
Yes, I am a con man.
Just got back today. Nice. Awesome. Awesome. Awesome.
Just a little something for my trouble.
Yes, I am sorry that I could not catch it live or donate while you were rolling because 4 a.m.
Senor, let us free. We will help you.
All right, let's shoot the locks.
Let's go, my friends. Reyes is getting ready to attack Allende's mansion.
Don't run in front of him. Don't.
Gracias, señor. Eres un amigo de México.
Anything in here? Probably not. Oh, I guess I can just push these chairs? Okay, hang on. Hang on. Chairs. Do I have to escort the chair? Oh, I killed the chair. Dang it. Geyser. Oh, okay. Sorry. Well, that person just disappeared into a cloud of blood.
All right, let's see.
Good range on the shotgun, I'll say that much. Okay. I'll switch to another weapon. That's what you want me to do. Shoot your hat off, maybe? Oh, that's right. You met Alice. Was it just Alice, or were you there with Alice and Prissy? But that must have been nice. What was it like eating lunch with a chicken? That's what I want to know.
Vamos, mis hermanos.
Sorry, a chicken. This might be a hang back in. Shoot and text. Pop that head up. Or your gut, either one's fine. It was awesome, nice. Hopefully I'm not supposed to be saving like everyone that I'm rolling with you. You duck?
You cowards make me sick!
Alright, we should be able to.
That's your work!
Chicken. You have more marabou? Ooh, nice. Which type of marabou do you have? You can't just save the good stuff because it's all good stuff. I don't know exactly how to say it, but the one that says like Appleton Propant on it is very good. Where are all these coming from? You're a lot closer than I thought. Okay, can we?
You are all phantom!
Oh, that didn't take you down. Great. Oh, you're on. Okay, you're on a mounted gun. I get it. Get it now.
My apologies, mister. Get the boss.
No! Cover! Oh, you're shooting the gun! You're not even hitting the dude! Fix that. I think they're just spawning more people to roll with us here.
Go for the machine gun jump.
Why, are there people coming up behind us now?
Wait while we get everything into position.
Okay. Are you clear? Well, I guess I should probably stop doing that unless I want to kill everybody. Shot you in the butt. Oh, I shot you in the other butt. Shot you in both butts, dude. Oh, wait, you're still alive? I didn't necessarily mean to shoot you there, but I shot you there.
The army? The suffragettes is more frightening.
Up there just getting shot over and over again. Can't really see too well with this shot your hat. Oh. What else do we have here? Bolt action might be better.
Traigan hachas! Eche la puerta abajo!
Are we going inside?
There are more coming up the hill!
Coming up the hill? Over here?
Defend
the gate, Joe. Nobody gets through.
Maybe you'll get one of them posthumous medals.
Well, I was gonna say, yeah, I should just use this.
You fools are about to be real sorry.
And this is definitely from an era when turret sequences were all over video games. Okay, can you stop shooting me? That'd be great. Does this refill health? No, that's the horse, right? This is what I want. What if I just keep shooting? They're all gone. They're all gone. We're cool. Are we through the door yet? I don't know why we're turning around, but okay. Oh, we're getting through the door.
Come on! We can still get to my stagecoach!
Go then! I'll cover you!
They're getting away! We have to stop them!
That is indeed Bill, isn't it?
Vámonos! Date prisa, cabrón!
Come on, John. Let's get to the horses.
Stay and fight me, you coward!
Ow! Get up! This is a much longer fall than I expected. Oh, hello.
A la batalla!
King on ya!
your mother!
All right, give me a horse. Let's go.
Come on!
Where the heck did they go? Are they heading north? Not appear to be heading north. Oh, the game's not gonna let me do that.
Stop doing that!
This might work though. Oh no, the horse. The horse have not started to move. Okay, down this way? Said disable the stagecoach. Let's see how that's gonna work.
I thought you were
Okay.
What the hell are you doing? Find my freedom, pendejo. Now shut up, you dumb ape, and get out of the wagon. Apúrate.
I'm coming out. Don't shoot.
Here. Take Williamson. Just let me live. I will leave the country, I promise.
You always was weak-minded.
You're the one who let Dutch drive you insane.
Dutch wanted you dead. We all did.
Well, I'm going after him next. I'll outlive all of you.
You always was a traitor, you bastard orphan.
Esta noche duermo en tu cama, cabrón.
I was going to say, why don't we just...
John. I'll come quietly.
Well, I was going to try to actually lasso him, but... You didn't let me. Thanks, I guess.
My people are free, and it is all thanks to you, John.
And to the people who laid down their lives. People like Luisa.
Oh, yes. She was very brave, and she will be missed. Who was she again?
This guy.
Your peasant girl wife-to-be?
Oh, yes, of course. She will have a day named after her. Laura's Day.
Luisa.
What? Oh, yes, I knew Laura as well. Magnificent girl. Like riding a pompous bull, it was, amigo. You never saw anything like her. Anyway, enough about sport. Let's get back to politics. I trust you will join us in riding on the Capitol.
I'd love to, but with Williamson dead, my jailers need me back in Blackwater.
Hey, ¿qué hacen? Levántense. Well, I must say, I'll miss you, John Marston.
I doubt you'll even remember me, Abraham, but it's been an experience. Good luck with the revolution. If you win power, remember why you wanted it.
Well, travel safely, amigo. Vámonos.
All right. No longer getting trouble from stealing horses, just like real life. Awesome. Where is this, Oh, yeah. The G. The G is a long way away. I don't think we're gonna ride all the way to the G. Whoa. Okay, horse. Calm down. Everyone's cool.
Yeah. Slow up. You want a ride, friend?
I do. I want you to take me to the waypoint.
Senor,
take me to Blackwater.
Get some rest, my friend.
Wake me if there's any trouble, partner.
And welcome to our main city here in this game. It's a pretty sizable piece of land.
Come here a minute, will you? Hello there, sir. You look like a man who can do an honest day's work for an honest day's pay.
Then looks can be deceiving, pal.
Perfect. As honesty is, in my business, the worst policy. I work for our well-respected governor, Nate Johns.
That makes sense.
Now, there is a certain individual spreading nasty rumors about Mr. Johns. I'd like you to put a stop to this vile gossip and malingering.
Suppose I can handle that? For the right price?
Now, this individual has had the misfortune to be photographed enjoying some rather inappropriate company. Been seen with a local whore. Take these photographs to him. After you take care of business, return to me, and I'll pay up the reward for your services.
Ooh, blackmail.
You're
let's go.
You're doing great things for your state, dear friend. You should be proud.
All right, where is that? Is that in town? All right, it's not that far. What?
Some mudsill just stole my horse. Pony up and stop him.
You gonna give me my horse or what? What's going on here? Come here, stupid.
Let's go.
Come here. What? Horse! There we go. My goodness, did you decide to run really far away? Always want to go where the camera is, don't you, John? Come we'll check in on that question mark in a little bit. I need to drop his horse off first. What? Oh my goodness, this game. Take that. Is this happening outside or inside? What's going on here? Looks like it might be inside.
Excuse me, miss. Something wrong?
Does it look like something's wrong?
Well, you look kind of upset about something.
Perhaps you don't understand what it's like to be disgraced as a woman. To have people gossip about you and turn from you in disgust day after day.
People can be real unkind, that's for sure.
Yeah. I'm Clara. I used to be a nanny for a family here in Blackwater. The father, he was always so charming. My fool that I was, fell for him. Mrs. Thornton, his wife, kicked me out on the street as soon as I started showing. Mr. Thornton turned to drink. Not even a farewell. For a dollar. I have nothing. They will surely take my baby from me. Perhaps you could find the dissolute bastard. Get even a few dollars for me and my baby to find a home. I would be so grateful, sir.
I'll see what I can do.
May I go mess him up? What's going on here? Okay. Oh, that's a sizable area to check. Let's go, horse.
Come on.
There you go. Easy. Oh, he's at the saloonery. Well then.
Hello there.
Peacemaker boy.
Excuse me. You know a girl named Clara?
What's that? Is she one of the waitresses around here?
No, she was a servant at your house.
The only servant we had was that wee darky girl, Sarah. And she left to join our people up north.
No. She helped raise your children. You and her had an intimacy of sorts.
Well, look here, laddie. I'm not sure what you're accusing me of. I'm just here to enjoy the tables. No to hear aspersions against my character.
I understand you want to keep this quiet. Just give me a few dollars so she can set up a modest household for her and the child.
You out of your mind, laddie, or are you just a common criminal? The nerve of you! You think you can blackmail me and insult me over this piffle? You, outside, no.
Oh, well. I guess we're gonna shoot it up here.
I'm so sorry, officer.
Hi there.
Need glasses, Marston?
Well, maybe if you weren't sitting there, I'd be able to get around you, but, you know. All right, let's do this.
Hello.
got him.
I think I got my eye back.
Don't think you'll be needing this.
$200? That ain't bad.
Hey, Clara.
Hello, mister.
Got you some money.
Oh, you are very kind. Very kind. And how's Harold? How's my Harold?
Didn't go so well. I'm afraid he's dead.
Dead?
Unfortunately so.
I must go to his grave.
Afraid I don't know where that is.
Oh, he'll be buried in the cemetery in the family plot. But hurry, I can make it to his funeral.
Well, that's a quick turnaround.
Let's go.
Looks like there is a house here that I can rent or buy. Green icon on the map, but I don't know where it be pointing.
That's true. I'm the Queen of England.
All right, sorry. Don't arrest me.
You ain't making it.
Looks like you haven't been pumped.
Upstairs?
I don't think so.
Well, it might be up here. Do I just own this?
I heard the first bank collect water, he's got no soul.
I just have a spot? I guess I just have a spot. That's fine. I'll take a spot. Looks like the sun might be out. Excuse me. I'd like to make an entrance. Alright, so where can we go here? Run over here. Might be looking for you?
Hey there, fella. What do you think of our governor, Nate Johns?
Nate Johns? Why, that no good lying backstabbing bastard. I'd like to see him horsewhipped. Why you ask, friend?
Need to make sure I had the right man. Would you care to take a quick look at a couple photographs of you coming out of a fine place of not much repute? What?
As I was saying, before I was so rudely interrupted, Nate Johns is a fine, fine man and an even better governor. And I consider it an honor to call him my friend.
Wise man.
Hello?
I don't think we...
Howdy.
Hello there.
Did your business. Hey. Hold that for $22? Oh, man.
Hello. Everything okay?
I'm here to see Mr. Ross.
107. 109.
Edgar Ross.
113. Upstairs on the right. 114. 115. 116. 117.
Okay.
Mr. Marston, so glad to see you. How was your journey?
Where's my wife and son?
Being well looked after. Well looked after.
I want to see him.
Mr. Ross wants to speak with you. We've had some important developments.
You want me to take out a gun and blow a fucking hole in your head right here? Right now? You want that?
Mr. Marston.
You want that?
Mr. Marston, I ask you to calm down.
Why? Why? I did what you asked. I got you Williamson and Escuela. It's over. Stop playing games with me.
No one's playing games with you, Mr. Marston. But if we were to play some games, there'd be some interesting ones we could play.
Thanks, sir.
Like hanging you for murder, or confiscating all your property, like that little farm of yours, or having you put in an electric chair. Those are the sort of games we could play. But we choose to play a different game. So calm down and play along with us.
Where's my wife?
You know, I forget, but I hear it's very nice this time of year. Mr. Marston, please, I've never insulted your meager intelligence. Do not insult mine. We've done this little deal for your freedom in exchange for all your men from your old gang. You gave us Williamson and Escuela. We still don't have Vanderlyn, but now we know where he is.
Then go and shoot him.
No, sir. I want you to shoot him for me. And then I'll let you be. The last thing I want to do is make martyrs out of all these people. He could be killed by some petty squabble by another lowlife.
We believe Vanderlyn is holed up with a group of renegades near the wreck of the Serendipity Riverboat.
Ah, yes. Another group of renegades. Obviously, the first group, your group, has, shall we say, been disbanded?
Disbanded.
Anyway, Mr. Ford and Mr. Marston, shall we go? Oh, Mr. Marston, your wife and son are doing well. Let's both try to ensure things stay that way.
Okay? After you, sir.
Oh, Mr. Marston, one more thing. This is for you.
You're too kind.
See, I have nothing but your best interest at heart.
Let's hope it doesn't go off by mistake.
343.
I have a patent for that, sir. This is an outrage.
Oh, hey, look who it is.
Mr. Marston, you're alive.
Hello, Wes Dickens. Thought you were headed to Peking.
So did I. Long story. But now it seems I'm being put under arrest and charged with narcotic possession or some other such nonsense.
Ross, have him release this man.
Why?
Because he's a harmless old fraud, the kind of man that built this country. And because he helped me get Williamson.
Did you hear that, officer? The man's a hero. Let him go. Come on, Marston. Moral degeneracy waits for no man. Let's hurry along.
344, 345,
348, 3...
These automobiles.
Head for the wreck of the Serendipity, Mr. Fordham.
Absolutely cruising. Isn't this something?
Lawmakers and lawbreakers working together for the good of civilization.
Like you always say, sir, the higher the stakes, the smarter you have to play the game.
I can't imagine I ever said anything quite so trite. In any case, I'm not sure Mr. Marston would agree with us.
Unfortunately, Mr. Marston isn't broad-minded enough to appreciate the unique opportunity we're offering him.
Son of a
whore. Best watch your damn mouth!
And it's strange you should say that, Mr. Marston, because according to my files, you are the whore's son. Now, what else can I recall from the files? Let's see. You killed hundreds of innocent people. You've robbed at least 40 banks that we're aware of.
They told us there was a prize when you got to 50.
I'm glad this is all such a joke to you.
I want my family.
And I'm sure all the men you murdered wanted their families, too. Come now. You're stupid. But you're not that stupid. We both know how this has to be. And it could be all over today. As soon as we find Dutch Vanderlyn, you can go back home and play being a farmer again, or whatever else you've been pretending to do for the last few years.
First it was Bill, now it's Dutch. After Dutch, it'll be somebody else. Where does it end?
It ends when we say it ends. You're in no position to make demands.
Like you live. You don't just walk away from that. Buy a few chickens and make it all disappear. You should be dead or rotting in a jail cell by now. We are giving you a chance at new life. A chance at redemption.
Ooh, redemption.
You can't erase your past, Mr. Marston, but we can.
All right, Nat, thank you for hanging out. I appreciate it. Have yourself a good evening.
She's running well, sir.
And take
care. Such an elegant way to travel. What do you think of this automobile, Mr. Marston?
Slow,
but so convenient and reliable. Are you comfortable?
No.
You see this, Mr. Fordham? The brooding cowboy. There aren't many of these left, you know. A bit of a cliche, admittedly. But still a dying breed. Like buffalo. Just as dumb, but not quite as noble.
They move most cows by rail these days, I hear.
Not where I'm from, they don't.
But you aren't from anywhere.
A new dawn is breaking, Mr. Marston. This is the age of the machine.
And soon, we'll all be living on the moon.
Maybe. This is the future. Anything is possible. Finally, this godforsaken land is entering the 20th century. Prosperity has arrived. It's not far now. The old Serendipity wreck has been used as an occasional criminal hideout for years. We were informed that Vanderlyn and his gang are making camp there. We'll stop on the cliff above, and you and Agent Fordham will go on foot. I'll stay with the vehicle and keep watch.
And you'll do as I say, Marston. Don't try anything stupid.
Oh, I think he knows what's at stake. Don't you, Mr. Marston?
Let's find Dutch and finish this.
Right. Let's go, Mr. Marston.
Yes, sir. Well, I can't even aim at him, so that's no fun.
Keep quiet and stay close.
Yes, sir.
Vanderlyn is the priority. We go in, take him down, and get the hell out of here. Quick and clean.
You leave Dutch to me. We don't want you getting that suit dirty.
If you step out of line, even once, well, I hope you're aware of the consequences.
Is there anyone even here? You would think they would have lookout, perhaps?
Seems real quiet, don't you think?
Yeah, a little bit.
You tell me.
Maybe Dutch caught wind of things. An informant better not have been lying to us. Keep your eyes open.
They are open. I don't see nothing.
It doesn't feel right. This place is usually teeming with lowlifes. Look where you're going. There's someone up there. You go investigate. I'll keep watch here.
The noise, huh? How am I gonna get up there? That's a good question.
Come on, those screams are coming from somewhere.
Yeah, zip your lip. How about that? Okay.
Over here! I found him!
Good God, that's our informant! Narcissus, what the hell's going on here?
It's a trap!
Shit, Marston! You'll have to carry this man! I don't think he can walk!
Devil!
What? Come on, we need to get him to safety!
Good question.
That's him. Oh God! What the hell's happening here?
Good shot, I guess.
Unbelievable. Oh my good God!
I like how you knew that was all of them. That's pretty impressive. There was someone else over there, but I guess not.
Come on, then. Oh.
Can't shoot the post. I can't seem to run, so I guess I am gonna have to follow this guy. Running seems to be impossible.
Who's this? What in God's name is going on?
Marston, lift this fellow into the back seat.
He took one bullet,
put
maybe
him in
two.
The car so we can get out of here.
He'll be fine.
Let's go! There might be more of them!
Yeah, there might be.
Christ alive! What the hell happened down there?
It was a trap. They were waiting for us.
And who is this savage? A prisoner?
This is the informant, sir.
Do
you speak English?
Yes, he does, sir. He's the informant, Nostis.
Don't get snarky with me, Fordham.
We found him tied up on the boat, then they jumped us.
Nice of you to help us out. Hell of a plan sending in two men to take on an entire gang of outlaws. Especially when one of them's an office clerk. Or social secretary or some
such. Just shut your mouth!
I don't think I can skip this.
Just gave out.
Well, fix it, you fool. We need to get this man to a doctor.
Of course, sir. It's Dutch's men.
Marston, we'll hold them off. Fordham, we'll fix that damn engine.
Crank it.
Come on.
Sorry, horse. Flip-flopping around down there. Stay still. I only have 8 shots left.
I can't see any more of them. Fordham, are we ready?
Yes, sir. I think so.
I just sat there cranking it for a couple of minutes.
Come on. Let's get back to Blackwater.
Damn, that was close.
We're lucky to be alive. I'm beginning to see why Mr. Marston here has made it to such a ripe old age.
You'll make me blush with all these kind words. So much for this
squeaky chair.
If this is the future, God help us all.
It's not the automobile. Bad workmen shouldn't blame his tools. Perhaps if Mr. Fordham maneuvered it with a little more finesse.
I was trying to escape an ambush, sir.
Even if it was running fine, they'd still have caught us. I can walk faster than this piece of crap. Give me a horse any day. So what now? Do I get to see my family?
Where is Dutch Vanderlyn?
I don't know.
In that case, old boy, no, you don't get to see your family. It's a fairly simple agreement, Mr. Marston. Even for a man as devoid of intellect as yourself. If you'd like me to explain it to you again, I'd be more than willing.
No, you've said enough.
We'll find Vanderlyn soon enough. For now, however, I suggest we call it a day.
So how does it feel, taking a man's wife and child from him? Does it make you feel good?
How does it feel to kill hundreds of men in cold blood?
You're a coward.
You're a murderer. Actions have consequences, Mr. Marston. Come now, try to look on the bright side.
The bright side? There ain't no bright side.
Your family is enjoying a much-needed vacation, and in far more luxurious surroundings than those to which they are accustomed, I assure you. Soon you will be able to start a new life together, absolved of all your sins. I can think of far more upsetting alternatives. We should take the Indian to Professor McDougal, see what he can get out of him.
Good idea, sir.
I just can't communicate with them. Here we are. Thank God for that.
So, this is the office of an anthropologist named McDougal. He was thrown out of Yale for a degeneracy.
Spelled Yale with a 6?
Indeed.
Oh, boy.
But he's been helping us deal with the natives in this area.
They see him and they presume we're all idiot academics.
Give me a hand here, Marston.
Ah, Mr. Ross. Mr. Fordham? Good day. Good day. What on earth's going on here?
Kid got shot in the leg. Beat up pretty good.
We'll send a doctor. Now, McDougal.
Mm-hmm.
We need information from this fellow about Dutch Vanderland. Can you see what you can find out for us?
Do my best, sir.
Make sure you do.
Professor McDougal has been a good friend of the U.S. government, Mr. Marston, just like you. Why don't you see if you can help him in his study of the native problem in this county? That's a good thought.
Yeah, that's not racist. Okay. What do we got here?
Hello, Marston.
Everyone knows who John Marston is.
Nice to see you there, Mr. Marston.
Taylor.
Come on in.
Tally a while.
Howdy. Shall I show what I have in stock?
U.S. military scrap. Okay.
Yes, sir. Please show me what you have.
And I can sell stuff to you for money. Okay.
Bunch of blocks up yesterday, and it doesn't sound long for this.
Is there a gunsmith in town here? There is, just down the street. Anything good? Ooh.
Want the best guns money can buy. Ooh. Came to the right place.
Look at all this stuff I can buy.
That's just dandy.
Do I really want to go and just
Wonderful.
Buy everything? Why not?
That should keep me going for a while. My mistake, mister.
Okay.
Careful, partner.
This is...
Hey there.
Ship Shape Shop. Oh.
Hey, partner.
You're a discerning consumer. That's why you've come here, am I right?
Okay.
Okay.
That should do it.
Let's see what you
got. We got a map. Okay. Let's go maybe pick up this bounty.
How do you do?
Hey, shooter, get your ass over here.
What's that? What?
How about I make you famous? All you gotta do is agree to a duel.
Duel.
Someone needs to teach you some respect.
Hey, shooter.
Let's do this. It's the worst that could happen, right? I get shot dead. I got him. I was like, why didn't it stop at 6? Then I realized I had the other pistol equipped. Are you happy now? Bruh. Ooh.
Wow. It's you, Mr.
Did you hear about the savages attacking that stagecoach?
Alright.
Last time I go to
Tanner's Reach. Danny Tanner's reach? That's pretty far away.
I'm gonna report on those turds for Brain's colleagues of mine. Well, you told me so.
By my blessed mother.
I gotta go. Bye-bye now.
Mr. Moss. Come on. Whoa there.
Now what?
Are we gonna be tracking this guy down at sunset?
Let's go. Let's go. Come on.
How about I do neither?
Yeah.
Is this a place I can buy? Oh, not enough cash. Well, I just spent a ton of money on other stuff, so. Maybe some other time. Fine.
Slow up.
You are way out here, my dude. There's snow in these hills. No, 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 no. No, no. How dare you, game? Any other time there's an edge like that, you stop the horse. That time, you just run into the drink and apparently drown, even though I was well above the water. Video games! Well then, should we ride out there again? Well, maybe I can just take a,
Mr. Marston,
everyone please move. Thank you. Where is the, it's up and to the left, to the left. It did look like there was another purple question mark nearby. Okay. So apparently we're a couple days later here. Am I not going the right way? No. I should be over here. Right?
Hello, ma'am.
Oh.
My condolences. Oh, my dear Harold, I can't believe he's gone. I knew his frequenting that gambling boat would be the death of him. The death of him. Oh, Harold Thornton, I miss you.
I see.
I heard that Doc Trollop Clara laughing at the funeral. I can't understand how strangers can be so cruel. The world is a sad and terrible place. God preserve his soul.
I'm sorry for your loss, ma'am. Take care.
Complete, huh? Okay. Oh, would you calm down, pup? If I could pet you, I would, but I can't.
Won't you join me?
I will.
Where are you headed?
Tall trees, please.
I'll let you know when we get there. Meantime,
I just need to close my eyes a minute.
Alright, so I think it would be smart to whistle for the horse before we engage.
Ready to go if you are.
Come on.
Please help here.
Nope. This is as close as you got me? Jeez. Dudes. To our friend here.
Now my recommendation is that you behave. I guess fun time is just beginning.
Turn me loose, man. My arms are sore.
Been eating well, have you?
What? Okay. I guess my horse died. Did you you mind, my dude? What do we got? A long ride back is what we got. Have a few red dots showing up on the way back, I would think. Peeled off pretty quick. Nice shooting, Tex. Oh, hello. White horse? No, not white horse. You just look like a white horse. What do we got on the map? Look at you.
Let's go.
Just go for the X because it's kind of in the middle of nowhere. Yeah, I bet you could.
Anybody think you're following me? If it isn't my...
Ain't this a beautiful spot?
Sure. What are you doing here?
My accounts. I'm an accountant.
Is that so?
In a way.
What's your name?
You know, it's the darndest thing. I can't remember.
Tell me your damn name and where you know me from.
Well, I know you're from Mexico. I know you're from back out west. Well, I know you from all over.
Tell me your name or I won't be responsible for my actions.
Oh, but you will. You will be responsible.
This is a fine spot. See you around, cowboy. Damn you! Yes, many have.
All right. I don't remember that at all, but that's fine. What I want to do next. Choo-choo train. Yeah, probably just go back and start one of those missions. What is the plant du jour here? Golden currants.
Go. That's one.
Wait till the morning for these. Oh, hello.
Load up now.
You're the boy who thinks he's some kind of fast, tough guy. Let's find out how fast and tough you is.
Do you really want to do this, dude? Alright.
Can't refuse a man his dying wish.
Okay, boy, let's go.
Alright, Trip Lockley. That is your real name. You're not going to enjoy how this ends. Told you.
I need it more than you now.
Why?
Do you sir? Support temperance, sir?
You, a scum who can become as angels if you just put down the booze. We are campaigning in Congress. We will save this nation from itself. In the land of liberty, men should be free to live soberly without fear that the perils of drink may overcome them. Do you like what you hear, sir?
Not particularly. You'll take away our last freedoms, friend. Freedom to forget about our troubles.
You don't have troubles, friend. You have all the joys of heaven here on earth if you just put down the bottle.
You don't know me so well, friend. If you did, you'd know how moronic that sounds.
I, Abner Forsythe, am not afraid to be called moronic, sir.
That I don't doubt. Good day, sir.
Oh, it shall be, sir. When we live temperately alongside one another, you are doomed.
Damn!
Damn! Visit the seedier side of Blackwater? Okay. Don't really have to twist my arm to do that. How seedy are we talking?
Mr. Marston, how are you?
I'm gonna see our buddy Abner bending the old Elba. Is that what's going on here?
Hey, mister. I heard about you.
Sure you did.
You that boy killed Bill Williamson over in Mexico.
No, got me mistaken, partner.
I ain't. Boy told me all about you as soon as you come to town.
Town? That's what you call this? What's wrong with cesspit?
You know, I saw you talking to that Abner Forsythe.
Who?
The temperance movement man. Man trying to put me in a poorhouse.
Oh, yeah. Interesting fella.
He's Jeremiah Somerset's pawn. The industrialist wants the state to outlaw public consumption of liquor so as he can make a fortune selling personal gin stills. Leave bar owners like me begging in the street.
Oh, my heart bleeds for the three of you. I just can't figure out which one I dislike the most.
You kill Abner Forsythe, I'd do right by you.
You'd find yourself someone else.
Oh. Kill him.
We gonna be given a choice here?
What are you still doing here?
I guess I'm being given a choice. What do we do? I know what we do.
You're that guy who kills people. How are you doing?
Drunkards, eternal misery.
This is what we do.
Oh God!
That was too close for my liking.
No!
All right, getting away from the cops might not be the easiest thing in the world. We'll see what the game lets me get away with.
No!
I did what you wanted. Fool. Someone can see me. Shoot me or my horse.
Let's go. Yeah.
Come on.
Come on, come on!
mister. I want to talk to you.
What is it?
I heard you killed Abner Forsythe.
Yeah, maybe.
Good job.
Next time, do your own dirty work.
Well, yeah. Anyway, here's your reward. You feel free to drown your sorrows in my saloon any old time you like.
I could use a drink.
Can't we all?
-100. Come on now. That's a little questionable.
Whoa, whoa.
Yo, Tom, welcome in. Hope you're doing well. Thank you for your contribution to the Zelda challenge. Appreciate it. Also, I got my haiku stuff. See if this actually works. Yeah, I'm ready to go. Just have to come up with a redemption or something to actually do things in haiku mode, but yeah. It cost me a whole $0 to get all this together. But I'll have to come up with a background that's like a very smoky bar or something to actually do it correctly. But yeah, I hope you're having a good one. Appreciate you stopping on by.
Hello there. I'm
a brick wall? Should I do a brick wall that has like a couple of tomatoes stuck to it, brick wall? Or should I just do brick wall with like some bad neon lighting or something like that? Can't just be a brick wall. It's got to have some character to it. I just don't know what. Have a drink. I don't want to have a drink right now. I want to make a hard save. The hardest save I've ever made. By walking into this table. That's what I want to do. Yeah, I can come up with a brick wall. That'll work. And then we just need the redeem for a haiku, and then... I don't know who would want... to hear a... haiku apprentice... actually try... something like that, but you never know. Maybe I'll come up with something funny. Although it seems very unlikely. Oh, that's some thunder in the background here. But since we are playing the game, let's go back to the cowboy hat. Kind of important. They don't have to be funny. They just have to be 575.
What a pleasant surprise, Mr. Marston. An informant just told us some interesting news. Our mutual friend, Mr. Vanderlyn, is about to pay call on his bank manager. What do you say to having a little financial discussion with the fellow? This way.
Let's get up on the roof. We'll have a clear shot at them from there.
The roof. The roof, you say? Oh, the roof. I just want to check the local radar real quick because it doesn't sound pleasant out there. Oh, here it comes. A little bit of orange, a little bit of red mixed in there. It's gonna start booming real soon. I vaguely remember this mission and it being a pain in the butt.
Every one of them is a rank amateur.
That door is the only way in and out of the building, so cover it tight. You see those horses to the left by the building across the street? Dutch's boys hitched them there. They'll have to run that way to make their escape. Don't start shooting until they're out in the open. If we spook them, they might retreat back and hole up inside. Don't shoot till I give you the signal. Keep your sights trained on that bank door.
I hope you know who you're dealing with, mister.
Don't shoot till I give you the signal. Someone's coming out. He's unarmed. Hold your fire. They shot him dead. They're coming out. Gun them down.
Yep. Not a sniper. Where are the rest of these? Oh, you're having a good one.
Take out those snipers in the window.
Sniper? Oh, yeah, snipers. Sure. Where's the other one? Oh. There we go.
Quick, they're running out the door. Kill them.
How many dudes do you have in there with only three horses? Left, this guy. Oh, you can dance. I see. What?
Marston, headed to the bank with Hopkins and Manny. Get Dutch.
Persona 5 Royal is available on the Switch for the paltry sum of $30. Worth it? I would say so. Absolutely. It is a long game. Even if you were to play through it mainlining, you are looking at 120 plus hours. I definitely think it is worth it. It doesn't quite have the heart that Persona 4 does, but I feel it is a better game overall, better experience. There's plenty of side stuff to do. Characters are interesting.
Be careful. There may be
I think it tells a very good story. Doesn't quite stick the landing, but I think that's more me than anything else.
Let's move! They'll cover the windows from up top!
So we're going in here and we're busting stuff up.
Marston, shoot the door open!
Shoot the door open? What?
Let's go!
Okay.
Watch out,
I don't think that's how that really is supposed to work. Ow! I'm dead? Thank you for letting me take cover.
Come on, let's get in there!
Alright, well, what if I just get the shotgun instead? We're gonna be close. Make it a crowd pleaser.
Shut the lock off that door! Damnation!
Really?
What in the hell? Hurry! Get us through that door!
I'm gonna cut your rocks off. Hey!
Wow. This is not the part that I remember being kind of stinky, but oh well.
Let's move. They'll cover the windows from up top. Over here. Marston, shoot the door.
I'm trying.
Watch out for hostages.
Alright, well, you are a hostage. Oh jeez, can we take cover?
Oh my god, help me! Please don't kill me!
Back the hell off or you die!
No! Please!
How am I supposed to... I don't know how you want me to do this game.
Let's
What? How dare you? What are we doing here?
Everybody out! Run! Now!
Look at that.
How'd I get myself into this?
Good work! Dutch ain't down here. He's gotta be hiding upstairs somewhere.
That's what you think? You think Dutch is back there, really? I think you're wrong.
Come on! Let's get in there!
Give me a second. Can I crack this safe? Am I gonna get any more prompts ever in this game? No prompts? Okay.
Oh, it's nice to see you, John.
Oh,
hello,
then.
Dutch.
He is here. Surprise, surprise.
How's Abigail? Well, I hope. Ain't seen her for a while. Because you've been chasing me? Let the woman go, Dutch.
Of course. Of course. How's your little boy?
He ain't so little now.
No, he must be what? 15? 16? Doesn't time fly?
Don't adjust. It's over, man.
Of course. Of course. I surrender, John. You're the master now.
I've been my master since you left me to die.
We all make mistakes, John. I never claimed to be a saint, but equally, I never took you for an errand boy.
Just trying to help my family, Dutch, by making compromises we all have to. Now let her go. It's over.
You want the girl, John? You always were the romantic sort. You know, gentlemen, this man here, oh, he married a whore. Used to ride with us. We all had her. But he married her. And you know that makes him a better man than us. He's a better man. Have the girl, John.
Easy, Dutch.
She's a parting gift from me.
Oh! Yikes.
God damn. I don't see him!
What the hell happened in there? This is your fault, Marston.
Oh, yeah, sure.
You too, Sheriff.
You waited too long.
Next time, I'll just shoot the girl. That's enough. Come on, let's find the bastard.
Get on your horses. I just saw Dutch make a run for it.
Gee up. Faster. Let's just say, Dutch ain't gone and got himself safe. He killed some poor woman.
There's an old logging camp further down this road. It's been abandoned for years. My guess is that's where they're headed. Come on, follow me. So that's the great Dutch? What a role model! The man who made you who you are.
I guess so.
Has he changed?
No, still the same crazy bastard he turned into.
How was it seeing him after all this time? Did he tug on your heartstrings?
He kind of reminds me of you. Violent piece of shit who went and confused himself with God.
Isn't that sweet of you? And now you must kill him. Your side is chosen.
My side ain't chosen. My side was given. I'd kill you 100 times before I killed Dutch, if it was an option.
Hallelujah! I think we're finally reaching an understanding, Mr. Marston.
Fire.
There's the car. They must abandon it and continue on foot.
Yep, they must have. Did I? Did I really? I don't think I did. Game. That one.
It's just me and you, partner.
Boy, this 360 is really struggling here. Shooting you in the butt.
Run away, pal!
Where's Dutch, Marston?
He got away.
Scared to shoot him? Too much to handle?
When the opportunity presents itself, I'll put a bullet in him, don't you worry. Won't like myself for doing it, but I'll do it.
Ah, good man, good man. You know, at the end of this, you'll probably get a medal. I know I shall.
Okay. Where are we on the map? We are down in Bear Claw, okay. I still have that $40 bounty on me. Alright. Let's set up camp out here somewhere, I guess. probably too late for you, right? Yeah. 7 a.m. and 10 p.m.
Sorry, I'm in a world of my own.
All right, what do we got going on here? We should save it up. As long as the power doesn't go out in the next 10 seconds, we're good. All right. Still nighttime, huh? So I'm making it my business to sit. Save it again. Now the sun's out. I think we still have a mission for our agent friend. But we need to do some of these.
Oh, incredible. Simply incredible.
Hello, Professor.
Hello, sir. Oh, Mr. Marston, sir. Good day. Good day. How are you?
Well, my family's health and well-being are being threatened by some unscrupulous government agents, and my own hard-won freedom is under duress. But these problems aside, I suppose I'm fair.
Yes, the problems of civilizing nomads. Tell me, sir, are you from Norse stock?
Not as far as I know. I was raised in an orphanage. My father was Scottish.
Unfortunate. You'd make an interesting case for my theory of natural population characteristics.
Really?
Well, yes, a white man, obviously, but with a savage spirit. Trust me, sir, I mean savage in the best possible sense. Natural nobility, but also simple, pure. I've been looking at some blood samples through my microscope, and you know what?
No.
Well, of course you don't. It's a remarkable breakthrough. I've been looking at the blood of both natives and white men of corresponding height, weight, and age, and you know what?
Again, no.
They're exactly the same. It's remarkable. It completely refutes my last book. But I'll tell you what, sir. This sabbatical in the field may have been somewhat forced upon me by circumstance, but my scholarship has benefited enormously. Would you like to partake of a syringe of cocaine? I've quite enough for two.
Not right this minute, no.
It's a remarkable drug. It entirely restores the ego. It takes one back to a primal state. It helps my thinking enormously. Oh, Nastas, come on. Come in, sir. Would you like to take off your slippers? Or skin a rabbit? I know we cannot see the stars, but still, my heart is pure, and we meet as equals. These savages must be spoken to simply in metaphors.
No, sir. I grew up on a reservation and attended school.
Oh, lovely.
But I can show you what you want to see. I know where the group of bandits you seek are hiding, both of you. Vanderlyn has attracted a following of young men on the reservation. They are turning to bad things.
The savage heart cannot be conventionally civilized. I was right all along.
Where's Dutch Vanderlyn based?
In the hills, in Cochine. Let's go. I know a way there that is not guarded.
Marvelous. Simply marvelous.
Marvelous.
Hello, sir.
Time to do our bit for humanity, Mr. Marston.
Follow me.
So, I understand we have a mutual interest in Mr. Vanderlyn.
You gonna kill him too?
Kill him? Good God, no. What is it with you people out here? No, Vanderlyn fascinates me. A white man living among natives. A civilized mind turned savage. It's reverse integration or regressive acculturation. I don't know. I haven't found a name I like yet.
He was never that civilized.
Ah, but of course. Edgar Ross mentioned your unique history with the man. Although I was away with the fairies at the time, I must admit. Surfing great waves of euphoria. But anyway, yes, some kind of Robin Hood, Oedipus, communist tale of naivete and betrayal, if I remember correctly.
We ran in a gang together, Professor. I wouldn't try to read too much into it.
It's my job to read too much into everything, dear boy. Look, Mr. Marston, buffalo. What a noble beast.
I see him.
The white man will soon be the end of them.
What on earth are you talking about, Nastas?
Too much hunting, sir.
Your whole society is based around hunting.
But we hunt to eat, not for sport. Soon, there will be no buffalo left.
Who teaches you this nonsense? Extinction is a myth refuted by Darwin. Species don't die, they evolve. Hunting in time will make the buffalo stronger.
Yep, good logic there.
These trees are quite foreboding, Nastas. Are you sure this is the right way?
Yes, sir.
It's rather dark.
It's this way, mister.
Ain't you never seen trees before? I thought you were a brave cultural explorer.
Good Lord, no. I rarely leave my room. I explore with the mind, Mr. Marston.
Enjoy it while you still can. Soon you will have cut down all of these trees.
Me? Or are you making a sweeping statement about the white man in general?
There is no respect for the land anymore.
I'm sensing some hostility, Nastas. Some anger. Talk me through this primal emotion, where it's coming from.
Don't worry about it, Professor. Climb the rest of the way. Hi-yo!
My horse just kept going, because why not?
Remarkable. I'm afraid I don't really have much of a head for heights. More of a head for highs. Well, anyway, I'm sure Nastas will help you. I must be on my way. I've got work to do.
Thanks for the help.
Goodbye, gentlemen. Enjoy yourselves!
Let's get moving, mister!
How many times are we gonna see that animation? Find a rope or something?
Another route, Mr. Marston. I will have a look around.
A rope? No? Okay.
I think there's a path through this cave.
Yes, look at this. A mine shaft. I'm sorry, mister. This way.
Careful where you're shooting.
Pretty bad.
I don't think you should go any further.
I'll be fine, but you go ahead. I don't want to slow you down.
Are you sure you're all right?
Just need to take it slow. Go on. I'll catch up or see you on the way down.
That sliced
don't worry about
pretty
me.
Good.
Go look for Vanderlyn. Good luck.
I tried climbing the rest of the cliffs. Apparently, that's not the way to do it. I don't think I can jump that high. The bear.
This'll fetch a good prize.
A bighorn, okay. Okay.
Oh, Lord, this is nasty.
Unskippable. In case you're wondering.
Hmm.
Birch. That's an eagle. I ain't shooting no eagle. We got these throwing knives. Apparently, if I throw knives at someone's legs, it takes them out. Puckleman Kev. Hope you're doing well. I'm gonna say that's evidence of Dutch. It's apparently a very good shot.
Mr. Marston. Here you go, Mr. Marston.
Put that stuff away.
You banged your head. Nastus and I carried you down. Well, Nastus heard the shots and he hurried up to rescue you and he carried you down.
That was a chance.
An escape plan.
A risk? That was a risk we were willing to take?
Thank you, gentlemen.
Friends of mine are with Vanderland.
We must try to reason with them.
Yeah,
sir.
The Avatar thing's fun.
Vanderland's gang contains
means
several
I don't
agents.
Have to look good for
we
the camera.
We must meet with them and try to save them from disaster.
My people have already endured many disasters. Before, this was all our land.
And now we have brought you civilization. Well, sure, it hasn't been easy, but it hasn't been easy for anyone, Nastus. Why, I knew a man in Yale whose father once shot 18 natives in one afternoon out in Wyoming. Oh, the man was quite traumatized. He took to lying with choir boys.
For a wise man, you are a very stupid man, mister.
Gentlemen, I'm going to leave you to figure out right from wrong.
You are simple-minded, sir. Thus, I do not blame you for not understanding reason. Then again.
Hello there.
Yep, I heard a wolf.
Hey, friend. Greetings.
We have another mission here.
I believe you're a bad
guy. Yeah. Yeah. What's next? Science!
Yes, finally got it. Finally got it. Animals and gods. Savages. Marston, sir! It's good to see you, old bean. Good to see you.
And you too, Professor.
Forgive me. I am in a state of remarkable agitation, partly due to standard narcotic impulses, but also due to the fact that I have finally solved the riddle that has tormented my mind these past 8 years.
What's that?
The nature of the savage soul! What makes some societies great, like ours, and others, not worse. I would never use a pejorative such as worse, but lesser!
Meaning?
What makes these beings less human than us? Closer to beast on the continuum between animal and god? You know, I argued with Fortescue at Yale about this. It caused a minor scandal. But I shall be proven right, sir. I shall. Mark my words. I shall show them all what civilization is all about. The redskins and the nubs at Yale. Come, sir. I have a way to sate both our desires.
I will bring you, Vanderlint, and me, the evidence of savages reverting to type! Come, sir!
Doc's been doing drugs again.
Where the devil is Nastas? He should be here with the horses. Where is he? Where is he?
What's up, dog?
Try to calm down, Professor.
I've never been so excited in your one life!
Hello, Professor. Mr. Marston.
Feels like a late and long stream. I got started a little bit late, and I'm planning on going a little bit later because I want to try to wrap this game in the bud, so to speak.
This is it! Years of research!
What were you talking about back there? Where are we going?
But I think we're going to have to stretch it to one more stream.
Wow, I think they call it. A meeting of minds, of souls. Indians and whites, academics and criminals coming together to find a common understanding.
Nostus, this fool's making no sense.
Some of Vanderlyn's men have agreed to meet with Professor McDougal up at Bearclaw Cabin.
Why the hell would they want to do that?
I think they are interested to find out what conclusions a white man has reached on hundreds of years of culture and society from the comfort of his hotel room.
Wonderful! Do you think I could ask for a skin sample from the soles of their feet?
I don't think that's a good idea.
I'm actually a little nervous, I have to say. A touch of the old jitters.
No kid.
It's no small relief to have the two of you along with me. Especially you, Nastas. You really have made remarkable progress in the short time I've known you.
I'm glad you have found it useful.
I've always been a little...
Whoa,
it's
there!
It's a bear! For the love of...
Oh, that's not good.
You angered her. Now we have no choice.
Oh, really? You're gonna make me kill the bear? Alright. Overkill!
Thank heavens! Now let's get out of here!
Let's go!
My goodness, I'm still shaking! What a ferocious animal!
That bear showed no signs of aggression. If we hadn't shot first, it most likely would have ignored us and moved on.
All very well for you to say, but perhaps you have some kind of primal bond with these animals, but I, sir...
This is it.
Whoa. Come on.
This game is unbelievable.
My God, that was terrifying!
All right, good
and
checkpoint,
I say we
at least.
Leave before any of its friends turn up. Have to smoke a pipe.
I don't remember this mission.
Hello, gentlemen. We come in peace.
Those words mean nothing coming from people like you. Look at what you've done to us. Look at us! We live like animals, scrabbling in the dirt.
Well, I... Well, violence isn't the answer!
Maybe you live in a different America than we.
Men like Vanderlint will lead you to disaster.
I think we've already experienced disaster. The likes which you could only imagine. Put your hands up!
We come in peace! Do as he says, Marston.
You call this a meeting?
Give me your damn weaponry.
This is not what we agreed to.
You shut your mouth, you treacherous snake! Holy shit!
Okay.
Professor, get down now!
I guess we're shooting our way out.
They killed the stars! night! No! Do something quick!
Stay down!
Oh, really?
Mister! You'll die a coward's death.
I think I had about enough of field work for today. Time to return home, sir.
Right. Let's go now while we got the chance.
What if I just loot all these bodies first? How about that? Okay, maybe not. Maybe all these bodies. I don't know. They're kind of nearby.
Just a little something for my troubles.
I want to ride that horse, but I guess I'm riding that horse.
Come on! Come on!
Ooh, chunky frame rate.
Oh my god, they're back! Do something!
There's too many things happening here. How did you get in front of me? I wish I had my horse. I'm working on it. I think we'll turn in after this one for sure.
That was the worst experience of my life.
I wish I could say the same.
Blackwater. I will never talk ill of you again.
Civilization in all its glory, Mr. McDougal.
And am I glad to be back. I'm in dire need of a syringe. Something to clear the mind and restore the spirit.
So you ain't planning on sleeping then?
Sleep? My dear boy. I'll probably never sleep again.
Well, with the amount of coke that you're doing, yeah, that seems about right.
Slow it up.
Hello, Mr. Marston.
Where are we going?
And sound. Thank the Lord.
So much for a meeting of minds.
Thank you, Mr. Marston. I could be boiling in a pot right now if it wasn't for you.
Get some rest, Professor.
I think the professor has another mission. Yeah. Doctor is down this way.
They say Marston's a real killer. I'll arrest him if I go on looking.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Or not?
Fearsome killer or not, Marston will not pass through Blackwater free.
No? Is it too late for the doctor to be open? Is that the problem here?
Hi there.
Not so fast, oh, partner. Hi.
Someone told me there's a town idiot that's going to learn to read.
Hello? Prompt to save game, please. There we go. Strange. It's still nighttime.
Nice to see you. You hear about the big shoot out that reckless serendipity? Some government man gave that gang a trouncing idea.
Oh, really?
Hi there.
I do beg your pardon.
Can you? Thank you. It's raining, but is the doctor open? Is this doctor never open? What is happening? Is it not open until 7? That's a problem. That might be the case, because it looks like the lights just turned on. What? There was no one in here! Come on. Where do I go to pay off the bounty? Let's just do that. Out here to my left.
He looked real terrible.
You clearly don't like me much!
Stop shooting me! It's not nice. It's not nice! Look, the real question is, why was there no doctor in there when I needed to visit the doctor? That's garbage. What is this, America? Wait a minute.
That Barrington Apollo Razor will give you the cheeks of a newborn.
John Martin, you can come around here and raise hell. I'll be sure to come.
Six p.m. and 5 a.m., okay. Ran the wrong way. Nice. There we go. Doctor icon, and then Doctor icon goes away. What the heck? No doctor here? Are you the doctor? What the heck's going on here? You're the doctor.
Dear sir, hello.
Excellent choice.
All right.
What do we have?
Is there anything that you want? Probably.
That's good. Thank you.
Well, I don't know what the prices are or anything like that. Anything worth buying in here? You have an upstairs, too.
Hello, sir.
If we don't have it, frankly,
thank you.
You don't need it.
What's upstairs? A side entrance? Okay. Just me getting hurt. Cool. Is there anything else on the map? Nope, just the two choo-choo trains. Our good friend McDougal. So I guess while I'm thinking of it, I can just pay this. That way I don't have to worry about it anymore. Oh, and there's a new bounty. Perfect. Zibbity Nash! Maybe not right this second.
I've learned the errors of my way.
Well, I mean, I can grab that and then just not do it, right? I think that's how these work. John Marston. Or I could do it. Stop saying help. Just stop. What?
Some bastard outlaw just robbed me. Please, can you stop him?
Damn, if you ain't cute as hell. Is this dude on a horse?
Marston. So you're here.
Horse?
Hello to you.
Horse. Who was shooting? Where did that other shot come from? My horse dead? Is this horse dead? No. Come here. Horse! Stupid. Stop. Get over here, you. Where are you going? Moving. Oh my god. These prompts are sketchy. Straight ahead.
Come on.
We're Macklin extra service. Hop on.
Take me to the waypoint.
Right, boss. We gonna get there. Don't fret.
Tall trees, please.
Go get some rest. We'll be there shortly.
I need to get some rest. Wake me up when we arrive.
I need to get some rest. I need to get some rest. I need to get some rest.
All right, boys. Here we are. Take the sound.
How close are we? Not very.
Welcome aboard. My name's Clem Ackley.
The
What's up, dear? Are these guys gonna pop off upon seeing me? So I'll throw some knives. Really don't mind. Okay, that worked really well. Everyone just running in a straight line to me? Oh, where'd you go? Alive, but you ain't on a horse. Okay, sure, yeah, sure, that's awesome, thanks so much. Can we? Holy crap!
You wanna stop doing that?
Turn. Back. Of course, it's very, very close. Me or not? What's going on? High power this pistol is really gonna be, but we'll try it.
Come on, come on! If you don't stop that, you ain't gonna live!
Thank you for shooting me right before I entered Blackwater.
Yeah.
Oh, this 360 is struggling so much.
I hope you found he's worth your life, my friend. I'll kill you, I swear it.
Load up now.
Here. You were...
$600, heck yeah.
Apologies, officer. You're doing a fine job.
So what is this nighttime mission? All right, let's see. What do we got? 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 More thunder is what we got, apparently.
Professor!
Oh, it's you, dear boy. Come in, come in, and shut the door.
What's going on? You leaving?
Yes, sir. Yes, I am, sir. Do you know the thing? The thing that is vital, without which scholarship cannot proceed, sir?
No, I don't.
Not having a bullet in your flipping neck, sir. I am not cut out for this. No, not cut out for this at all.
Nope.
They're fucking savages! Savages!
You love that word.
Like we all are.
Not me, sir. I'm from Connecticut. I'm a professor at Yale. I write books. I do not deserve to die out here. Where's my tincture? Oh, yes.
You okay, Professor?
Oh, dandy, sir. Just dandy. Oh, great heavens above!
Is that you, John? Hello, Dutch. I think that's what they call two for the price of one out here in this wonderful place. Maybe so, Dutch. You and your friend there, the professor, we're gonna kill the both of you. Why you wanna do a thing like that? I don't know. Sport, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Fair enough. Why don't I come out there? We fight. Let the professor go and send your boys back to their families. Well, that sounds like a beautiful plan, John. Only problem is, my boys here, they already lost their families a long time ago. We aren't thieves, John. We're fighting for something a bit like you. Only we're fighting for an idea. Not just for ourselves. That's beautiful, Dutch. You always were a fine speaker. I was. Now, would you kindly send that academic out here so we can show him what we really think about the art of anthropology?
Please, sir, what are we going to do?
I'm gonna hand you over to him and watch him tear you limb from limb.
What?
I'm just kidding. We're gonna run across the rooftops. Get you back to your ivory tower.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. We're still here. Come on.
Yes. Oh, come here.
Oh, yes. Good day, sir. Madam.
Look here, sir. What is the meaning of this outrage?
You two stay down and shut up.
Come on. We can get to the roof this way.
This will go well, I'm sure.
John! Help me, John!
One more move, and he's a dead man. As the buzzard flies.
God, you took your sweet time! What do we do now? They've got us pinned down on both sides.
Okay.
You ain't outlaws! You're idiots!
You better follow me.
I was about to...
One at a time. Thank you for the Wilhelm. Appreciate it. Okay.
What do these people want from me?
I'll shoot you in a minute, McDougal.
Come on.
Are you having fun yet? Christ's sake.
Trying to see where they are here. Oh. Another chimney here. Oh. It's a little buzz.
Break for it!
Yes, let's.
Come on! Let's get out of here! The horses should be in an alleyway down here!
Come on!
Yoink.
Right! To the station! I'm not staying in this place a minute longer! This really couldn't have gone more horribly wrong!
At least you got some good material for your next book!
You know, I dreamt of documenting the last days of the Old West. The romance, the honor, the nobility. But it turns out it's just people killing each other!
It always was, Professor! And the Old West ain't quite dead yet.
Oh, I know, Mr. Marston. Believe me, I know. Leave me alone!
So where are you supposed to be riding to? What station?
No! Here they come again!
Oh, jeez. Well, that helps, but...
Come on!
That definitely went well.
Let's go!
Where are you going?
Let's go! do now?
Here we are. A one-way ticket to civilization, please.
Apparently, we're going to this train station instead of the one that was in town.
My research is complete. Much as I thought, there's no civilizing this savage land.
I could have told you that for nothing.
Ah, but they'll give me a prize in New Haven for this. Well, they bloody better. Well, goodbye, Mr. Marston. Best of luck, dear friend.
So long, Professor.
So long, sir.
Okay. I can't move. Oh, there we go. So this is a place where I can do stuff now. There's a general store. And there's a place I can purchase.
Always happy to see a customer.
Howdy.
The selection bothers and confuses me. They always do. And there we are. Enjoy the journey.
All right.
That's good. Thank you.
Produce 5 cents a pound. Boy, howdy, would that be nice. All right, so we have our next G mission, which is what we're going to kick off our next stream with, I think. We should have the money to afford this. You're not gonna let me into my property here? There we go. Save this one up. We will call it a stream right at about 3 hours or so. And I think I'm down to, well, let's find out. Apparently I'm getting raided on these missions, which is good, I guess. I don't know. Missions complete at 46. Okay. I think we should be able to wrap it up in one more stream next week. Just make it a longer than usual one, and I think we're good. Oh, I'm not going to raid out tonight. I'm just going to chill. But thanks everyone for hanging out. I hope you all have a good evening, and I will see you next week, when we continue playing Red Dead Redemption. Goodbye, everybody.